Let's now check the situation at schools in Metro Manila's northern cities. ABS-CBN's Rafi Santos joins us for an update from Camarin High School in Caloocan. Good morning, Rafi. What can you tell us? Rafi? All right, we'll go back to Rafi's report in a while. The Mayon volcano, meanwhile, in Abay, placed under alert level 1 following signs of low-level unrest. The Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology, or PIVOX, reminds the public to steer clear from the volcano's 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. That's as they warn of possible phreatic eruptions, as well as hazards such as rock falls, avalanches, and ash bursts. PIVOX also advised people living in valleys and active river channels near the volcano to stay vigilant for sediment-laden stream flows and lahar in the event of heavy rainfall. Mayon is the most active of the Philippines' volcanoes. It last erupted in 2018. Millions of students return to school today. Let's head on over to Quezon City. Our correspondent Jeff Caparas is at the Batasan Hills National High School. Jeff, what can you tell us?
Hi, good morning, Mickey. Classes are now ongoing here at Batasan National High School. And a while ago, they did the usual program they used to do in the face-to-face classes. They did the flag raising ceremony and other ceremonies here. Earlier also, Mickey, NCRPO Police Brigadier General Jonel Estomo, together with QCPD District Director Police Brigadier General Nicolas Torre, inspected the school, and they said here in NCR, they deployed 9,721 police personnel, and they also have installed a police assistance desk and instructed all the policemen to conduct foot patrol and motorcycle roving. As of this time, there are no untoward incident reported to the police. We've also talked, Mickey, to Escolano Eladio, the school division's office assigned in Quezon City, and he is also the principal here at Batasan National High School. According to him, there are a total of 19,507 students enrolled here in Batasan National High School, and it's slightly higher than the number in the pre-pandemic, where they recorded almost 15,000, and he said the reason of which is because some private school have closed, and in result, the students have transferred here in Batasan Elementary, Batasan National High School. Mr. Eladio also said that the pandemic and the transfer from private to public has an emotional effect to the student. So they included a psychosocial support to their curriculum, where they teaches the student a proper meditation, a prayer, and to adapt to the new environment. As of now, Mickey, we are seeing that the weather here is gloomy, and the traffic outside at the IBP Road, those are going to Commonwealth Avenue, are now experiencing moderate to heavy traffic as of this time. Mickey.
And Jeff, just to remind us of what happened last Saturday with all the DSWD fiasco, how's the area looking? In Batasan Hills.
Can you repeat that, Mickey? Just like a
last Saturday.
With the update of the DSWD, is that what you're asking?
Mm-hmm.
Last Saturday, we've talked to the officer in charge of the
DSWD
station 6,
looking
that,
as of
Batasan
today.
Police. I'm sorry? Can you repeat that, Mickey?
Jeff, I was asking, how is Batasan Hills looking as of today following the fiasco, the DSWD thing last Saturday?
Well, outside the school, we're seeing lots of force multipliers, like from the barangay and from the depots. There are no untoward incident reported here at the schools because just last week, they conducted a dry run in preparation to the opening of classes today. In fact, they opened three gates to so that there are smooth, the students can enter smoothly in the schools. With the DSWD fiasco, last night, I got the chance to talk to the officer in charge of the police station 6, and they said They are now monitoring the DSWD office, and there are still no untoward incident as of this time, Mickey.
So we're not seeing long lines over at Batasan Hills this morning?
Yes, we're not seeing any long lines now. I can speak earlier last night, I did not see any lines there at the DSWD office. Mickey.
All right, thanks for that update, Jeff. You stay safe.